Well, hello again. Thanks for joining me again in this week's newsletter. This is the third week of the legislative session, and I'm recording this on February 3rd, so on Monday. One of the big things that's in the news these days, you've probably seen, is that coronavirus coming out of China, the illness that's killing people in China. It's having effect on certainly our air travel, but it's also having effect on oil prices. It's causing a significant drop in oil prices. As China closes down, they're using and demanding much less oil. Consequently, for us as the state of Alaska, the price of our barrels of oil is down around 60. I've heard even dropping down below 50 or below the $60 a barrel mark. That has huge implications for our state's budget. So I just put that out there. All of these factors, global factors, affect Alaska's economy because we're part of that global economy through our oil industry. So just wanted to point that out. Got a lot of bills and work on the agenda this coming week. Today in the Senate Finance Committee, this morning we heard the motor vehicle fuel tax proposal. This would double our fuel tax from 8 cents a barrel to 16 cents a barrel, bring in, at low estimate, about $30 million a year. This would be designated to be used for road maintenance. There's also a doubling of the marine fuels, going from, I believe it's 5 cents to 10 cents. That, again, could be designated for harbor maintenance, for example. The bill was heard today, a lot of discussion. There is an element missing from the bill, and that is addressing alternative fuel vehicles, electric vehicles, hybrids, even LNG vehicles. So that piece will probably be added to the bill as it goes through the process. So that was heard today. Tomorrow in Senate Finance, they're going to be hearing a spending limit bill. Now, we know that a spending limit is wildly popular with Alaskans. Certainly, we all want to make sure that we're keeping downward pressure on government, that we have a limit in how much we will spend. We have a limit in our Constitution right now, but when it was written back in the early 80s, there was no provision looking at inflation, population, things like that. And that spending limit is actually $10 billion in today's dollars. That's excessively high. What's going to be proposed on the table tomorrow is a spending limit of $6 billion. That leaves a little bit of headroom for increase in population and inflation, but there's also provision in there for inflation that spending limit would creep as inflation crept up. It would exclude from under the cap response to emergencies. It would also exclude capital expenditures, so that's building stuff like roads, for example. It also would include the appropriation that the legislature makes every year for the permanent fund dividend. So the first discussion of that will be tomorrow in Senate Finance. So that will be interesting. And probably in next week's newsletter, you'll see that link to that hearing and also the paper, the materials. This week also in Senate Finance, we're going to be getting the supplemental budget, we think, from the governor. The supplemental budget is expected to be somewhere around $300 million. This is the largest supplemental budget that we've ever seen in our state's history. The reductions that were made in the budget last year, many of them were not able to be realized. The most prominent one has to do with Medicaid. The governor had hoped to be able to get a waiver from the federal government that would provide the ability to lower Medicaid costs. We didn't get that waiver. So that's a big chunk of the supplemental budget. Another big part of the supplemental budget are all the fires that occurred this last summer. And there's other elements as well. So we'll be looking at the supplemental this this coming week. I believe it's on Thursday that it's scheduled in the Finance Committee. Last year, the legislature, as we worked with the governor, managed to reduce our budget by $351 million. It appears that this supplemental budget will eat up most, if not all, of those savings. So that is unfortunate. Then moving on, the Education Committee is going to be hearing the reading bill again this week. That bill focuses on reading competency. I am a big supporter of it. We want to see a focus on reading. We know if the foundation of reading skills is laid by the time a child leaves third grade, they are much more likely to succeed during the rest of their school career. Up until third grade, a child is learning to read. After third grade, they are reading to learn. Reading, that is, being the basis of their ability to learn going forward. Labor and Commerce this week is hearing a bill that makes some pretty significant changes to our licensing procedures. So I'm watching that bill very closely. Community and Regional Affairs will be talking about our Village Patrol Safety Officers, VPSOs. This is the rural law enforcement that you've been reading so much about in the Anchorage Daily News. So that bill is going to be heard. That subject is going to be discussed. That'll be an important meeting. State Affairs is also going to be talking about a law that would address background checks for village public safety officers. The Community and Regional Affairs Committee is also focused on energy. They're going to be looking at hydroelectric, possibly some nuclear options that might be available for Alaska to lower the overall cost of energy, not just on the rail belt. We all, many of us watching this newsletter, live on the rail belt, so that's a concern, but rural Alaska as well. Isolated communities need to have some other options for the cost of energy. And in Resources Committee, there is a rewrite of some mining statutes, particularly for small miners, placer miners as they're called, some of the paperwork they have to do. So everyone is hard at work here in Juneau. I hope you'll continue to watch not only these newsletter videos, but also the information we send out. We try to give you a diverse menu of information, stuff that's kind of local, having to do with parks and things like that, but also a lot of fiscal stuff too. So thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next week.